Hi guys, this is Rioforce here, and I'm going to explain to you today in Blender 2.67b how to create this render I made a little while ago. As you can tell, it looks fairly realistic, but most renders that people make, especially with Lego, they're all too perfect. You have to have a trained eye to look for the imperfections, because if it's too perfect, it's obviously a render. And with photorealism, you do not want it to look like a render. So, let's get started with my tutorial. This tutorial will cover basic shading and bump mapping of Lego. So, first of all, I want to show you how I made this, how I got the detail into... First of all, I made the textures by scanning in Lego bricks and retracing them in Inkscape, and basically that's it. You can actually download the textures. I'll put a link in the description. So first of all, I took this photo of Johnny Thunder, which I had just bought from a yard sale a few weeks ago, and as you can see, there's a lot of imperfections on the minifig, such as this one actually has a marker on his mouth, unfortunately. His hat looks grainy and bumpy, sort of. His arms, they're not perfectly reflective. Just a little bit of depth of field on the gun. And there's some seams on his arm and on his legs. And under his hat, you can't tell, but there's a seam. And on the bricks, there's a little dust on them and such. And yeah, so there's a lot of imperfections. So basically, I took into account all those imperfections by... well, first of all, to make the Lego... okay, I'm lost. First of all, we will start by... I'll explain how I made this entire... just the basic shading of the basics of the minifigure without any bump mapping or imperfections. So yeah, let's just move him to layer 2. So basically he is all the way shiny all over, and see, if you'll notice on his hair, it's reflecting my HDR skybox map, which is actually just a picture of a Lego minifigure that I took. I didn't have anything better at the time, but I think it worked because it has a variation of color in it, which makes it good for interior looking scenes, such as my render, which looked like it was on a floor. So how I made this, first of all, I attached a diffuse node with an anisotropic node with roughness of 0.02 and anisotropy or whatever to 0 and rotation to 0. So basically it's not really anisotropic, it's glossy, but glossy was just too bright for me. I'll pull up some test renders I made while I was still working on it. So, this is the anisotropic right here. As you can see, it's a lot darker. You can see some seams in his leg, and you can see the bump mapping a lot better, and the seams and imperfections. And this is glossy. As you can tell, glossy is a lot brighter, and you can't very well see the seams as much. And didn't like it, so I stuck with anisotropic, and this is the result of that. And so, instead of using glossy, I used anisotropic, as I just said. So I set the mix shader, so basically I'm mixing these two together, diffuse and anisotropic. I used a mix shader of 0.05, so if it's on 0, if you'll notice, On zero, it's all the way diffused. Diffused is like just nothing. It's no glare, no specular, no reflections. And on total one, it's all reflection, all. It's just like a mirror. And if I had roughness all the way down, for example, it would be perfect mirror. See, he's reflecting himself perfectly. But since I put it to 0.02, he has a little bit of grain in him, so the reflection is not as sharp, which is more accurate. So I use 0.05, I think. Yeah, I use 0.05 because it is not too reflective, because if it's too reflective, it doesn't look real, and it's not too dull. It's pretty much the right value, but it's a matter of opinion and how you look at it. But I think this is working. And this bright contrast node, which is an experiment, I plug in the texture, which fits to my UV map right here, my texture. I just plug it in to the diffuse, and there's his texture. But I have multiple UV maps set up right here, textures. I'll show them to you. That's textures. It fits with my UV map. And this one is cube, which is basically, I pressed U and clicked cube projection. And then I scaled up the head and torso because it didn't need as much butt mapping. And this one is details, which is another UV map, which I made specifically for the seams in the legs, the head, the arms, etc. So, since there's three UV maps, which one is the image texture going to use? Well, that's where this attribute node comes in. If you'll notice, if I set cube to the default right here, UV map, this is what happens. It does not look at all good. And if I set details, that's even worse. Oh, well, not that bad, but yeah, it's not good. So sometimes you need multiple UV maps, and if you don't know which one to use, so I just made attribute, named it textures for the textures UV map, plugged in the vector into the vector, and now it knows which UV map to use, even if I change UV maps over here on the side. Now to the bump mapping. I'll copy over some lights real quick, some lamps, so we can see it better. For the bump mapping, basically I created a group, which is just nodes that I created, and then you just select them and then click Control G, and that creates a group out of those selected nodes that you created. So this is my bump map, and I'll go ahead and show it to you right here rendered. As you can see, it adds a lot of detail, and there's a seam right there. Well, you can't hardly see it because it's still rendering. And if you zoom in to like his belt right here, you'll see lots of bump map and imperfections here. And on his arm, there should be a seam. Yeah, you can see it's not the best, but it's a seam. And that's all I really did with my bump mapping. And here's the node setup. This set of nodes I'm about to select is the node setup for the cube mapping, which is the Lego bump map. Right here. I created my own bump map by just scanning in a 2x4 slope brick. You probably have them. They're really rough on the side whenever they're slanted, usually. There's some are smooth, but most of them are rough. So I just scanned one in the scanner. I should have done better quality, but I mean, you can just change your DPI in the scanner. And that's just how it turned out, and it works brilliant for a bump map. I stuck it into Photoshop and tiled it. And there's plenty of tutorials on how to make tiling textures in Photoshop. And then I stuck it into here as a bump map. I used this Well, I'll explain these nodes. This vector node's for the cube mapping UV over here. This mapping node is for, I use it for the scale right here. I'll toggle hidden, that didn't work. Oh well. This scale is what I use, because if I had just used the bump map as is, one scale, like if I hit him on that to avoid it. Now, it's too small, or too, actually it's too large, so you can't even see it bump mapping hardly. See, like right there, where my mouse is, on right below his gun in his belt, it's too large and bumpy. So I use the mapping node, which I scaled it up so that there's more times of the tile, is tiling more. And so now you can see it looks a lot better. It looks more realistic and everything. So then that vector goes into the image texture, and that goes into the mix node. The mix node is here to level out how much bump map I have. If I avoid this mix node, you'll notice that everything turns really white looking. And it's all, everything's on 100% bump map. So it's all sticking out as far as it can. And it does, and it diffuses the light way too much. And by the way, diffuse just basically means spread out over a surface, I guess you could say. So if I use this, set this color to 1 on the mix node. Set 0.05, which I found was a good amount for the bump mapping. And then plug this in to color 2, just like that. Then it will bump map it to my the right size. And I'll go ahead and explain these. We know what the attribute in the mapping is. This one's for the details map. And the details map is not really much. It's this. Yeah. It's just a bunch of lines I drew following my UV map. Not that UV map, but this UV map. And so it's basically the seams on the minifig. They're not the greatest right now. I drew these in the Blender. In Blender right here, just hit paint and you can draw all kinds of stuff. Okay, so that's just the details map. So, if there's the image texture details map, I inverted the color, because black actually means outward. So if it's black, it's going out bump. I wanted it to indent it, not out go out. So I inverted the color, so the black turns white and the white turns black, and so forth. Like blue turns yellow and such like that. So that's what the invert node does. I'll show you, maybe. You can't really see what it does if it's not inverted, but it's way better inverted, because I wanted the seam to come out, not go in, because that makes more sense, because that's what's real. I might have a picture of a seam in right there. If you'll notice, that is a seam. And over here on this other arm, it's all dented up. Well, I didn't want my minifig to look that bad quality, so I didn't dent it up any. But that's the seam, and that's the imperfection. So that's why I did the seams. So I set this one to 0.007, which is, you don't need at all a large amount for this. If I set it to 1, as you can notice, the seam is awful. It's black because the light is hitting it. It thinks it's so deep, so the light is hitting it deep looking, or actually it thinks it's outward. Yeah, with the invert node, it looks like it's going in, if you'll notice. It looks like a mountain or something, I don't know. So I set it to 0.007, which is a good amount, and I kept it inverted. Now we're going to this add node right here. This add node is actually combining these two mix nodes, which are all these textures over here, at a 0.5 amount, so it's getting equal amounts of both, and it's adding this details map on top of the textures map, which is the, no, on top of the cube mapping, which is the Lego bump map, the plastic look. So, I thought it would be better, I haven't actually experimented if it was the other way, but I thought it would be better if the white, if the black and white picture added on top of the, well, it's black and white because it's bump mapping, but I thought it would just look more refined, like, because it's putting, instead of, it's putting the details map on top of the bump map. So if I would swap these around, there would be bump map on my details map, which sort of looks better, actually. Wow. Okay. You learn something new every day. Anyway. So I just kept it that way. You might want to actually keep the bump map on top of the details map, because now it actually looks more realistic. And sort of. Maybe just a little bit more bump mapping might be in order, but, you know, I'll just keep it the other way for right now. I'll keep experimenting. You know, it takes a while to get photorealism down. It's kind of complicated. You gotta observe a lot and take lots of photos. So, then this is the textures map, which is, I scanned in a very dented up piece of Lego, and, nope, that one's not real. I might be able to, anyway, so, basically, the dented up piece of Lego looked like that much, just this, what's in the torso area right here? That, under that, is what the original torso looked like, with the scratches and the bump and all the white in it, which, because I converted it to black and white and turned up the contrast and sharpened it in Photoshop Elements. So then I just duplicated it all around, so that way it looks really dented, and for the smaller parts I had smaller dents and such. And so that's basically how I made the dust map, which doesn't make much difference unless you're looking at something that's black. And if you'll notice right here on his gun, there's large dents, or not on his gun, but on the handle. There's lots of dents in it and things like that. All those are from this dust map is what I called it. It's really dent map, but it doesn't really matter what it is. The best way to get photorealism is basically just scanning in lots of, well, for Lego anyway, scanning them in instead of redrawing them, because redrawing them, I could never get the accuracy of this little dust map. So this add node up here is basically the exact same thing as the other one, and I just added the textures, the dust map on top of the cube map and the details map. Because if I put them the other way, you can't very well see them. So the next and final bump mapping is, which one is this? I think it's another layer of dust mapping. I don't actually know. Let's look. Yeah, I added two layers of dust map for some reason. What? Dust map, copy. Dust map. Okay, well this one on top up here was not actually real because it couldn't find its image. So that's basically nothing. So I didn't actually have four, I only had three set up for some reason. I thought I had four. Okay, and that's basically the basics of bump mapping. And so I stuck it on this scene. But before I explain about this scene, which I might not, I'm going to explain about this gun right here. This Johnny Thunder's rifle. Move to layer 2 right here. Let's hide Johnny Thunder real quick. Johnny Thunder, I just modeled this from a reference image. I just stuck the gun in the scanner. like always, I'm always sticking stuff in the scanner. And I just scanned it in and straightened it up in Photoshop by rotating it a little bit. And I just traced over it basically with my knowledge of Blender. It was not too hard. And I added a subsurf, which is a subdivision surface because it's really low poly without it. And I just modeled the gun, but how I made it all look dull was simple. All I did, as you can see again, just a diffuse and an anisotropic, since I didn't need a texture since the diffuse was, it was just one color, which I used the official Lego color off of Bricklink. And it's the exact, almost the exact same node setup. The details map, actually I just carry over the same details map. You can't very well see the details because of all the bump mapping, but there are the occasional scratch and such, because the details map just happened to work for the gun also. So, but this time on the cube mapping, I increased the amount to 0.4 instead of 0.007, which I think was last time. Yes. And if you'll notice, now you can see the details mapping, which is all these little streaks in it, scratches and such. So 0.04, I think it was, maybe 0.04. No, 0.04. Yeah, it was 0.4 because the light can't very well reflect off of it because it's diffusing it so much. Now, if you'll notice, the thing about bump mapping, if I turned it all the way on diffuse, there's no bump map. It just looks like a texture. That's because with diffuse, the light hits it differently so that it is, there's no glare, no mirror, no specular. It's just soft, bland, flat shading, basically. And so, you need, see, if you turn up all the way onto the anisotropic shader, you can see it looks so much bump mapped because all the light is reflecting off of it. It's hitting it directly. So I, of course, put 0.05 and mix of good color and gloss. And so it's just basically a bigger bump map. There are more bump mapping for the gun. And for the hat, I just added lots of bump mapping. Under the cube map, I actually put it to 0.1 value. I could have used 0.02, but that would have been too shiny. See, if you'll notice, 0 is like almost reflective. 0.02 is like normal brick, but if I used a 1 value, of course it diffuses it out too much, and I don't remember which one I was just using. 0.1, yes. A 0.1 value is the right amount, and I kept the same details map, which I don't know how, but it's been working for all of my UV maps. Well, almost. But all I did was just cube map it over it and called it, no, am I the right man? Yeah, all I did was just use a cube map and call it details. So I just hit U and then cube projection right there. And that is all that I did. Fig. And that is the render. Just like this. So, be sure to check out my blog, rioforce.wordpress.com.